Last two on the bid on for Jonathan Milan, who's tucked in there in the blue jersey. And here we go. Time to turn ourselves back. In fact, we're further down the course than I thought we may well be. Another right-hander will introduce us to the last 500 metres, or what will be so, at the end. Big open road to play with here, Brian. Next time by, this will be the venue for our sprint.
Yeah, this is the long straight in towards the finishing line. So, you know, they'll come over the finishing line shortly, but a very reduced group now in front, about, almost maybe 30 riders, if that. Laurence for B&B Hotels is lurking as well, but a very select group. Huge effort from Guerin here in the King of the Mountains jersey, but I think it's all going to come to nothing. So as soon as we come across the finishing line and up this climb for the second time, I'm really expecting something from some of the overall contenders.
I'm expecting something from Omar Fraile. He's just almost acting as road captain at the moment. Guerin looked back and you can see the twitches of his head saying, come on, this side of the road, that side of the road. He's guiding them all in. He's like the joystick at the moment. No joy for, I'm afraid, for Guerin. He's been caught on this one. And you can see a lot of space, danger of some riders actually being lapped. Seen that before here in Zagreb. Screaming through in the long shadows being displayed for you. Moric in a very good place. He's got Milan doing a huge turn for him. Past the theatre once again. And indeed, they head out and onto the climb once more. 5.8 from home, Brian. Time for the hurt, and they've already started to stretch out on the nose here. Here we go.
Yeah, I don't think we see anything from Mohoric in Milano, just to make sure that he looks after, but it does look as if Ineos Grenadiers are setting something up for an attack, but I think Milan has got this one covered. He's got Butrago and Mohoric on his wheel, but this is a perfect opportunity now for Oscar Onley to try and do something. I'm pretty sure he will try something on this climb because, you know, if he does it, I think it'll be kind of game over for him. It's going to be very difficult now to get any seconds back.
Well, the pace that's being instilled for now is a difficult one. Whoa, that street furniture as well. Speary either side of it. On the bottom of your screen at the moment, he's in about position 15. That's a bit too far back just for now. Here we go. I think this is Kenny Molly that's picking it up for Bignol Powell, trying to do so, trying to fight his way through as well as Jonathan Milan in the blue jersey. He's got Matej Mohoric absolutely locked onto him. Human Powered Health also want to get involved today. Not sure who it'll be for them. Arvid de Kleine, I would have thought. Meanwhile, looking further back, and it is Omar Fraile, who just thinks about hitting the front. He's playing with the bins at the moment. But whose nose is he putting out? That's what we want to know. And Mohoric never going to be that far away from the point, and making a big one is his teammate Milan in the blue jersey. Time to dig in for glory. Where is Onley? Just spotted him. He's not that far back. And indeed, looms large all of a sudden. There he is in the white jersey. And on his back wheel, of course, Jonas Vingegaard in the red leader's jersey. It's kind of now, if you want to take advantage of a situation such as this. Butrago was also in the frame here to help out, but it is Omar Fraile who hits the front now, and so he'll be guiding everybody down. He'll come off the chatter of the cobbles, take this left-hander and then engage with the pace. Gone a bit cagey all of a sudden, and it's Bahrain that hit out, Brian.
Yeah, this is it. Caruso now keeping a high tempo. They want to stop any attacks whatsoever. Omar Fraile is there in second place. Kim Hajduk in third place, and Brandon Rivera with Mohoric well placed. This is looking a lot more likely for Bahrain victorious. They just want to keep the tempo high. This looks as if it's going to come down to a sprint. Mohoric will be led out from the man in the blue jersey, Milan. But Oscar Onley, what can he do? I think that was his opportunity, maybe trying to go over the top. So I think if I was Vingegaard, I'd be a little bit nervous now coming into the sprint. So the only way that he's going to keep a hold of that jersey now is if some others are involved here with the sprint finish. And I think Laurence, if he takes some bonus, I'm not too sure who else is the sprinters that are left in this
Viviani.
Group behind. But Viviani, yep, and definitely there. He's up there towards the front. So, yeah, it's not over. Mohoric, on paper, not as fast as Viviani or Laurence. So, yeah, there's still a lot to be played for here.
They want a piece of this. Just about everybody who's got some quick legs would like to get involved. Alexis Laurence is indeed the man from B&B Hotels, has got himself into a favoured position right now. Albanese is also there as well from Il Cometa. So who's going to commit? That's the big question. And the white jersey, I think, still being shadowed by Vingegaard. It looks like Mohoric is going to have some fun. Caruso is going to be part of the lead-in, but the blue jersey is where you need to look if you want to find Mohoric. He sits just behind Milan, who's in that blue jersey, but Viviani wants to make a statement. He's come up. He's been very, very quiet within this race. He's got a huge lead out, 3.2 kilometres to go. They're on the downhill, run for home. And Viviani, I'm starting to think, well, maybe if they know that Brandon Rivera is not going to shake it off, it's a Viviani kind of day. But at the moment, the pace still being instilled here by Caruso. This is on behalf of Mohoric, who of the favourites has got to be up there. But is there going to be any room? He's got a lot of Ineos Grenadiers men. There he is. And suddenly sailing around the corner comes Sacha Modolo. He wants to make a nuisance of himself. Of course he does, in the plum. On the radio there, probably saying I'm thirsty, is Oscar Onley. Well, no chance of a beat on bar right now. Only 2.6 kilometres to go. Not quite sure what he was issuing in turn. Possibly an oath. Who knows, with the sort of equipment he's got around him. It's anyone's game. 2.5 kilometres to go. Coming into town. A couple of 90-degree turns to happen right now. Big turn coming in right now. It's the big left-hander. This bleeds almost immediately into a right-hander that will take us down to the 2 kilometres to go marker. The road will straighten out ever so slightly. They're still not fully engaged. It won't be until the last 500 metres because of the turns, Brian.
Yeah, this is a perfect for Viviani. He's got the numbers in front for a lead out, and you know, he's actually got four riders in front. You know, Milan has got Laurence behind him, Mohoric is there. A reminder that Mohoric only has to finish first or second. It doesn't matter if Viviani wins the stage. As long as Mohoric gets second, he takes the race lead. But so many other riders trying to get involved with the sprinters. Laurence taken out there by the looks of things.
Oh, wow, 1,800 metres to go. They all seem to get back up rather quickly, which is good. Some have been misguided. They've gone the wrong way. I don't know whether they've been gated as lapped. I don't think so, but we've lost some riders over to the right-hand side of the road, I believe. Post that crash. Oh, my goodness. It's stripped out a lot here, Brian. We'll see who went missing. Meanwhile, it's Ineos Grenadiers. This is your crash. But more than that, 1,500 metres to go. We're going to have to leave him behind for the time being. There is Mohoric. You can see with Milan just ahead of him in the blue jersey. Make-up time, cannot see Onley. I think he's got tagged, maybe even misguided. I'm not quite sure, but the DSM crew are there. Can he possibly find something out of today? Not sure. They are rebuilding themselves. DSM trying to find something here. And here is Vingegaard just getting himself back in. Massive opportunity then for Mohoric, possibly because of the crash. Where is everybody? There is Onley at the bottom of your screen. Did get disturbed by the crash. This is a huge moment. And it's the drive for the line right now. And Sky pick it up. Beg your pardon, Ineos Grenadiers go for it. They're also getting very much involved is Milan. But as you can see, Mohoric is on the case as well, wearing number three here. Oh, sharing a bit of shoulderage as well. It's getting very, very busy out there, back down there, I'm afraid. Rustenga wants a part of the day likewise, but Viviani is in the bird seat at the moment. But what sort of position can Mohoric get? Time to go right now, and a perfect lead out coming here from Jonathan Milan. He goes to the centre of the road. Milan in the blue. Viviani, of course, wants the victory here, but Mohoric wants something, wants a piece of this. If he can finish second, he takes the title. Oh, my goodness, he's done it.
Done it.
Viviani takes the day, but Matej Mohoric wins the title. And the crash was very much part, I think, of the result here today. And it means that we have a change of leader of the race at the very last. How dramatic was that?